Oh, it feels so good to be back in the win column. A well-fought series against the freeway rival Los Angeles Dodgers. Well done, Angels.
Yes, it was certainly impressive that we won 2 out of 3 in the series, but the guy, or player, that is on the back of this t-shirt was not a part of any of the games in this series because he's injured, which stinks. But overall, like you, I'm very happy that the Angels won that series, and now we will go on the road to play our hated rival, Houston Astros.
So before this series started, at least a few hours before Game 1, Dodgers pitcher Trevor Bauer put out a post on his social media. He's very active on that social media of his, and it had this to say.
Are you sure about that?
Okay, that is a very bold strategy indeed, Mr. Bauer. Let's see how it played out in Game 1.
Baseball, it is the start of the freeway series 2021. Well, let's see what the Dodgers can do with second and third and one out. Matt Beatty grounds the first one that he sees into the shift that I brought up again.
All right, well, your strategy is good for right now.
Will Smith scores and Matt Beatty ground out. Puts one more for Dodgers.
Correa has a 1-0 lead to play with. Upending back in the lineup for the Angels. He had missed the last couple of ball games.
Oh, man.
He sends a ball to left center field. That one's well hit and gone.
Jeez.
First big league run batted in. Bats with the runner at second. Into the opposite field.
Oh, good swing.
So two gone now for the top of the order, and David Fletcher has had a nice night already with a couple of hits and 2 runs batted in.
That's into right field, and that's down for another knock for David Fletcher.
Bauer, you wanting me to take back what you said there, bud?
Oops.
Well, something like that. It just goes to show, friends, that what you do post on social media, once you put it up there, you ain't getting it back. It's there for everybody to see.
That is that correct.
Has social media and follows Trevor Bauer. Unbelievable. The Angels dominate Game 1, but in Game 2, the script flips. The Dodgers jump out to a 13-0 lead?
Holy
wow. That is pretty big to say the least. However, this is probably the first time this year where the Angels truly show that they are the never say die Halos, which I remember we used that phrase in the 2002 World Series. But down 13-0, the Angels rattle off 4 runs in the 6th inning with a couple of RBI base hits and 7 runs in the 7th inning.
Impressive.
And Jose Rojas picked up his first career home run in the bottom of the 7th off of Dodgers reliever Garrett Clevenger.
And this man's last 10 hits have been doubles.
Oh, man. Wow, that went a long way. In real time, when you saw Clevenger's reaction, he kind of knew it off the bat of Rojas there. Unbelievable. That ball traveled 868 feet. Still hasn't landed yet. But it wasn't enough. But 14-11 after down 13-0 is something very impressive. And if I had my hat here in my hand, I would give you a tip of the cap, but I cannot do it because I'm wearing the glove on my head. In the final game, everybody's favorite opponent, Trevor Bauer, squares off with... Oh, that's right. I remember. He went against the Hall of Famer known as Jose Quintana. And Quintana, while his command is just way all over the place, he still concerns me on that mound. He held his own, giving up only one run, but he walked like five batters, even though, and struck out five or six batters as well. And he surrendered only two hits in his outing, which is pretty hard to believe. This is what I believe we would call effectively wild. Chris Taylor gets an RBI single in the top of the third, but in the bottom of the third, with the bases loaded, Jared Walsh would drill a two RBI double down the right field line and bouncing over the fence for a ground rule double and gives the Angels a 2-1 lead.
Nice.
2-1 would end up being the final score of this game as the Angels take this series. Yeah! The bullpen holds on against the talented but depleted lineup of the Dodger Blue. Aaron Slagers goes 1 1/3 innings scoreless. Then Alex Claudio gets a scoreless inning. Tony Watson induces a big double play from Will Smith, not the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air Will Smith,
bruh,
the catcher for the Dodgers, Will Smith. Mike Mayers gets a great scoreless inning with a couple of strikeouts. And Rizal Iglesias, while he made it a little bit nerve-wracking in the ninth inning, putting two runners on and only one out, he battles back to get a fly ball out, and he gets one of the better hitters in the game in Justin Turner to roll one over to Phil Gosselin, everybody's favorite player on the Angels, to field a grounder to him, force out at third base, and the Angels hold on by the skin of their teeth and win 2-1. And with that now being said, let's talk about our next series in Houston. Playing in Houston has been tough for the Angels, and honestly, it's a bit nerve-wracking, to be honest. The Astros have all their regulars in the lineup, because they're all back from injury. They do have a couple of injuries in their bullpen, specifically the likes of Enoli Paredes and Blake Taylor. But there's still a lot of talent in the lineup for the Astros. Angels lost Jose Iglesias to some back issues, so he's on day-to-day. Hopefully it's not an IL situation. Alex Cobb went to the IL with a blister, and we will discuss who is taking his place in just a second. It's a shame that we're getting all these injuries, because it's going to be hard to survive the month of May with all the injuries that we have. Chris Rodriguez is expected to return soon, and it's Joe Maddon said he wouldn't rule out activating Anthony Rendon on Friday for Game 1 in Boston. Now our pitching matchups for this game. We're going to do the bullpen game. This is something that Joe Maddon is not a fan of. It will be an opener, so we will roll out with Junior Guerra, the veteran, who we signed to a minor league deal this offseason. We liked what he saw in the preseason, and we got his purchased the contract. So he will open tonight, and Jose Suarez is going to take his place. Oh, no. Suarez has been... He had a couple good starts like a couple years ago, but since then he has just been horrendous. Let's pray that he can do something. But if anything's proven, he's a better pitcher than I am. And he's a lefty.
Correct!
They will go up against Luis Garcia. Yes, that one. The benefit of this series is that we're not facing the best starters for Houston in Christian Javier or the veteran Zach Greinke. In Game 2, we will get Shohei Ohtani on the mound. He will hit tonight in Game 1. And he will go up against Lance McCullers Jr., pretty solid season thus far from Colors. But we've done pretty good against him, even though we only got a couple, two runs on him last time. He was really good in his start against us last time out. And in the third game, we're going to get the lefty Andrew Heaney going up against Jose Urquidy. Urquidy's had a couple of good starts to move him to a winning record, specifically 3-2 with a 3.51 ERA. The players to watch... I'm making a new addition to this list in players to watch, friends. We're going to add Jose Rojas to the list. He has started to come around a bit. The start of his coming around came in our last series in the Juice Box at Minute Maid Park. I think he had like 6 hits in that series, and even 2 of them off of veteran Zach Greinke. Let's also keep our eyes on Mike Trout, of course. David Fletcher looks like he's coming around as well. And let's also watch for Shohei Ohtani. Hopefully in Game 2 we can see him go from both sides, the mound and the plate, batting. For the Astros, they've got all their regulars back, as I've just mentioned. For them, let's keep our eyes on the very good angel killer known as Michael Brantley. Mr. Smooth, they call him, or Uncle Mike, whatever you want to call it. The angel I am so stupid. Yuli Gurriel, the angel killer at first base, is my second player to watch. And let's also keep our eyes on the man that I do not like at all on Houston, and Carlos Correa. I am not a fan of Correa for pretty obvious reasons. Those are my players to watch. Let's talk about the predictions. Hopefully these ones are a little bit better than the ones I had for the Dodgers series. With how depleted we are in terms of our offensive players, and the fact that we've lost a couple of our pitchers already, even though we got Watson back from the IL, we're going to lose this series, sadly. And we're going to lose Game 1 tonight with the bullpen game. And I got a score of, I'm going to go with a score of 8-5 for Game 2. I think that's the game we can take with Ohtani on the mound versus McCullers. Hopefully Ohtani has his command on that game. He's been also kind of effectively wild, like I mentioned with Quintana's last start. Angels should win this game 6-4, and Andrew Heaney versus Urquidy. While Heaney has had quite a few very good starts, 4 of his last 5, I believe, have been in the quality start category. I have just a funny feeling that the bullpen's going to screw him over again, and we're going to have a repeat of what happened when he was in Houston last time, which is why I predict the Angels lose this game by a score of 4-3. So, low-scoring games. Let's see, I probably am going to be wrong in all 3. I usually am wrong in everything, except for with the one exception being the second game of that doubleheader against Houston at home earlier this season. So those are my predictions for this series, and that is going to do it for this episode of Angels Recap. Leave to me the thoughts in the comments section below this video. And remember to go check out Rosoff BBQ as soon as I get the new episode uploaded. Episode 4 is up for you all to see if you haven't seen it already. Please be sure to subscribe to the channel, as well as the like button. Click it. Click the bell in the corner for the notifications. And with all that being said, have a good day, stay safe, and let's go Angels. And let's see if our pitchers can pick up a win tonight. Go Angels!